Hey guys, welcome back to another video. Today I'm making a full tang drop point hunting knife. So the first thing I'm doing here is I'm marking the steel with a black marker so then I can scratch the design onto the steel with my scribe. Once I've got the design scratched onto the steel, I cut it out with an angle grinder. Next, I shape it with a used belt on my bench grinder. This piece of brass is what I will use as the guard, so I'm marking the thickness onto the steel so I can then file the blade to the correct dimensions to allow the brass to slot in slightly. Here I'm using a height gauge to mark around 0.75 mils away from the edge of the steel. That leaves around 1.5 mils of steel left before heat treat. Then I ground the bevels. Once the bevels were ground, I marked and punched the points where I will drill some holes. Unfortunately, I lost the footage of me drilling the holes. Next, I light my forge and heat the knife up to when a magnet does not stick to it, and then dunked it in the oil. It was tempered off camera at 180 degrees for an hour. After it was tempered, I flattened the surfaces. Here I'm using a marker to blacken the edge, so when I scratch the middle of the blade, I will be able to see it more clearly. I then ground the blade to make the edge around 0.3 mils thick. I then hand sanded the Ricasso to get rid of the surface rust. Next, I got a piece of brass and marked how long it had to be, and then how thick the blade was, and how much material I had to remove from the brass. After it fit nicely, I roughly shaped it and then polished it to a mirror finish. Here I'm applying some flux to help the solder flow into the correct places. Then I heat the blade up until it can melt the solder and apply it. Once it cooled down, I used a piece of scrap metal and shaved off the extra solder. Now that's finished, it's onto the handle. For the wood, I'm using a beautiful piece of stabilised fiddleback Australian blackwood. Then I cut the wood in half and flattened the halves on my disc sander. After they were flat, I traced and cut out the shape of the handle. And then the same with the G10 liners. Next, I cut 4 brass pins. Next, I got some double-sided tape and used it to stick everything together so I could flatten the fronts off and then drill the holes. Once all the holes were drilled, I used some acetone to clean everything and get a good, strong glue bond. I let it dry for 3 days. After 3 days, I got it out of the clamps and I roughly shaped the handle. It produced a lot of dust. Next, I refined the handle with sandpaper, starting at 320 grit and going up to 1200 grit. After it was sanded and I was happy with it, I sharpened it on some paper wheels, then strapped it with a piece of leather. Next, I oiled it with some tang oil and buffed it so it was nice and shiny. The paper wheels get it super sharp. And here's the finished product. It turned out beautifully.